Yeah, Ursa Major's mission and vision has always been to develop propulsion for products ranging from space to hypersonics, and now we're growing into missile propulsion and other derivatives. For a space launch vehicle, about 50% of the complexity and failures come from propulsion alone.
The challenges that we face, I think, for developing our products is that we strive to go through the development process very quickly, and we have to put a lot of effort into developing highly reliable and very effective products quickly. And so it's all about figuring out like what the intelligent shortcuts you can take are to make sure that you're getting the best product to market as quickly as possible and in the hands of the people that really need it.
So for rocket engine propulsion in particular, it's really some of the most power dense machinery ever designed and built by man. You're really pushing the limits of everything we know from metallic production or analysis. Every component of a rocket engine is really stressed to its limits. For example, we measure the lifetime of a rocket engine in seconds because we know that's about how long they last. It's really challenging to really get the design to a spot in which you know you're getting the maximum performance from every part. Generally, those problems can only be solved by analysis because you can't always test in space. So our analysis tools are really critical in making sure that the customer knows that our hardware will work, whether it's going from ground to space or staying in space for a long time.
Simulation is really important for us because we want to be able to predict failures before we test something. Even identifying where we think something's going to fail and understanding the risk is super important.
Simulation has been a great tool, and it's used really early in a program or a concept to get us kind of in the right direction, and it's used extensively toward the end of a development cycle to make sure that we've gotten the maximum amount of performance out of something. But what it does inherently is reduce the amount of hardware spend that we have to go through and lets us fail on a computer before we have to fail in real life.
Having the opportunity and access to the Ansys suite, I was able to learn so many things and really change the way that I approach problems because of the tools that we have access to. We spend time customizing the tools that we use in Ansys to really homogenize the results and the analysis packages that we create. And that allows us to have a very shared language when it comes to our analysis.
So it's this great coupled approach. And additionally, with software, modern software, we are able to reduce the number of people it takes to go develop something, which means individuals can do way more than they used to be able to do.
At Ursa, we do pride ourselves in testing really fast, getting that cycle quicker to get that feedback loop. But analysis lets you even speed that up to get some amount of iteration before you have to purchase hardware or wait for lead times on specific equipment and just machining processes and waiting for people to get through the whole build process.
Simulation has been pivotal in making sure that we get really close to the final results on the first try. And so far, it's been really useful in getting us here.